brother George. It is as I feared. London has fallen. Thrice I have written to you, begging your aid. Thrice you've responded with silence. And yet I write again. So desperate my need, so few my options. I need you. London needs you. You would say it is too great of a task, or that it is not yet time to strike. Patience, you would counsel. But whilst you wait, the Templars consolidate their power. They have chosen a Grand Master so ruthless, so thorough, one might think Reginald Birch himself had returned. His name is Crawford Starrick, and he intends to rule the world. There is no aspect of society he does not control, no industry that escapes his grim touch. By day, it is corrupt merchants and venal politicians who hold court. Come night, a vicious street gang known as the Blighters strikes terror in the hearts of all. There is no business untainted by his poison, no person unexploited, be it by duplicity or force. Our enemy has designs on the highest office of them all. And so, as you look inward, and dare I say it, afraid, Crawford Starrick's ambition is fixed on the beyond, to kingdoms and continents as yet unconquered, though not for long, for he knows. As I have warned you time and time again, whosoever controls London controls the world.
The iron ship's from here. The Templar running things is Rupert Ferris and our target one. Target two is Sir David Brewster, who's got his hands on a bauble that could ruin us in this wretched war. Think you both can handle it?
What a question.
All right. My mistake. Ladies and gentlemen, the unstoppable Fry twins. See them nightly at Covent Garden.
George, honestly, I've studied the plans of the laboratory and have every route covered.
And I've got all I need. Right here. I'll extend your regards to Ferris.
Chat later, George. We've a train to catch.
Take her! Evie! May the creed guide you, you vagrants!
Poor man. More afraid than ever. Years have not been kind.
Evie Fry, where do you get it from?
The same place as you, Jacob.
Send me some laudanum for my head.
Coming right up.
Here you are, shouting like a bunch of French revolutionaries. What can you do to achieve by blocking the factory doors? The machines will continue to run and wait the ball without you. Do you not think there are hundreds who are far worse? Do you not think there are one country in prison?
blocked.
What do you think you're doing?
Stop now, before there's trouble!
No one goes in or out, lest there's a problem.
I halt the machines. That door opens, and I have my route to Ferris.
The
sanitary inspector. This man is dead.
You're the dead man!
Run along home. I'll teach you how to beg for mercy. Any last words?
Ground.
Like a mess.
objective is to keep the peace.
We can do that. We've always managed before.
I'll rip your tongue out!
A good discussion.
Mr. Ferris, sir, the lad in the factory should be taken to be bandaged by the apothecary.
Fine, but dock his wages.
Yes, sir.
Should we arrive at a final price, Mr. Ferris?
someone! He's right there!
What is this?
Did you accomplish, boy? A bolt loosened in Starek's machine. A large bolt, but not enough.
Your Grandmaster will fall.
You assassins can circle London to your heart's content. The mechanism we have built has been going strong for 100 years and will run 1,000 more. It is the very city itself.
We will take London from your hands.
From Croydon. You lurk in the shadows like a coward. I doubt it.
bust your bottle, boys!
We seem to have made an unscheduled stop. Maybe next time I'll walk.
Yard. Guard quarters. Bruce's laboratory. This is where the Piece of Eden will be located. No loose ends. Now, decouple the locomotive and create a diversion.
Well, where is it? Huh? Where's Brewster's supplies? Meter.
while I head into your lab. Follow me down the tracks.
You stay here. Keep a lookout.
All right. I'll shout if I get any bother.
First for a bird's eye view. Can't be too careful.
I would have come apart.